Now, going back to our top story, the massive flooding in parts of the Visayas and Mindanao, we now have on the line Diego Agustin Mariano of the National Disaster Risk Reduction and Management Council. Welcome to the rundown, Mr. Mariano.
All right. Good morning, and good morning to all our viewers.
All right. Good morning. Now, earlier in the program, we had Eastern Samar disaster official describing to us the situation there. Can you now give us an update? Talk to us about the national casualty count, if you will, for those areas affected by flooding and landslides in Visayas and Mindanao, and perhaps the number of affected persons in the run-up.
All right. As of this morning, we have the latest data. As of now, we have, unfortunately, we have 10 casualties, which are 10 dead. Mm-hmm. Five are from Region 5, one from Region 11, and four from Region 10. Then we have two missing and four injured. Then for the number of the affected families, we have 106,961 affected families. That is equivalent to 438,622 individuals. From that number, our displaced population, or the people who are inside the evacuation centers or living in their relatives, we have 2,144 families, or equivalent to 8,153 individuals. So far, that is our latest data on our affected numbers. Yes. And casualties.
Yes, Mr. Mariano, you're talking about data. Of course, this is the total count now for national, representing how many towns, cities, or municipalities, perhaps, or even provinces.
We don't have the exact. I don't have the exact number at hand of how many municipalities are. These counts, but what I have is the number of regions that are affected. Mm-hmm. These regions are Region 2, 3, Calabarzon, Mimaropa, then Region 5, 6, 8, then Region 11, 9, and then 10. So then Barm. So that's the regions that are affected by this recent rain brought by LPA.
All right. On that list, of course, which do you think is the region or municipality, city or town that's badly hit, the most severely hit by the recent flooding?
All right. If we will be counting on the affected families, the most affected is the Region 3 and Region 8, and then Mimaropa. With the Region 3, they have 30,000 affected families. With the Region 8, 13,000 families. Then on Mimaropa, they have 24,000 families. And MIA add is also Region 11 with 17,000 families. So if you're looking at the numbers of the affected families, these regions are the most affected by the recent rain by LPA.
All right. Now, I know it's too early to really determine the scope of damage of the LPA and the torrential rains in the past week. But is there any estimate now, or are you getting, in fact, are you getting any figures as far as infrastructure and agriculture damage?
Yes, as we speak now, reports or the numbers of the affected damages or the cost of damages are coming in. Mm-hmm. But as of now, as of this morning, for the cost of damage to the agriculture sector, we have 142,327,192 worth of cost of damage to our agriculture sector. Mm-hmm. Then to the damage to infrastructure, we have amount of 165,745,496 worth of cost of damage to our infrastructure.
All right. The president made the rounds of some of the affected areas in Mindanao in the past days, and he has mandated relevant government agencies to come to the aid of those affected. What kind of assistance have they been given so far?
The initial assistance we have given so far is the family food pack and the essential other essential non-food items such as hygiene kit. Mm-hmm. And sleeping kit. Then to add with that, we will also be giving other construction materials to help rebuild their homes. Those will be coming from the OCD and from the district, no, from the housing department. Mm-hmm. Then the LGUs are also continuing giving their own food packs or relief items led by their local chief executives. Then from the national government, the FWD is also spearheading the giving of this assistance. So as of this morning, we have already given 26,861,252 worth of assistance given to these affected families or affected Kababayan brought by the strength of LPA.
Of course, Mr. Mariano, we will just get a clearer picture of the damage and the total number of towns and barangays affected as soon as clearing operations are done. Can you give us an update on this effort right now?
Clearing operations are still ongoing, and it is led by the DPWH with their heavy equipment and their manpower.
Okay.
It is also assisted by the AFP, PNP, BFP, and PCG. With their manpower and with their equipment as well. So these operations, clearing operations, are still ongoing. No? And while the rain is pouring, we expect that flooding and more landslides are also be expected. So these people and these agencies are still on standby, whatever possible. If ever there will be more rain, they will be still there and to continue their operations and clearing operations.
Okay, and do you know of any specific area, village, or even municipality that remains isolated as a result of flooding and landslides?
I don't have the exact location of their isolated areas, but we have the numbers of which are flooded areas or areas that have presence of flood waters, no, such as in region 9, they have 22 areas that are still flooded.
The rains might persist. So what are the priorities as of the moment, given that this is not over?
Yeah. Our efforts on giving assistance and rescue efforts to our Kababayan in need is still ongoing. No? So our first priority is first to get out, to get our people away from harm or those who are trapped due to these flood waters, then bring them here in the safety or in our evacuation centers. Once they are here in our custody or in the safe places like our evacuation centers, then that's the time we will be giving them the relief packs or the food packs that they will be needed during their stay here in the here in our evacuation centers. Then after that, we will also be assisting them in their rebuilding their homes and or rebuilding their lives back in their respective places, so they can start their lives again after this flood has gone or the rains has gone as well.
All right. On that note, we thank you so much for joining us this morning, Mr. Diego Agustin Mariano of the National Disaster Risk Reduction and Management Council. Thank you so much for the insights and the information. Have a good day.